monster. Here comes big fish. I got him. There's the leader. I want to go really slow with it.
Dinosaur, folks.
Oh, baby. Yes, yes. Oh! Oh, he's thinking about it. He's going to come back. Here he comes. He can eat it this time. Oh, come on, you. Oh, I'm trying to make it look like I'm struggling. Come on. There's another one there, too. Oh, I wonder if I should get a little spoon down there, maybe. Here's what we do. We're going to give him the little spoon. He'll eat this. Oh, here he comes, racing in. Look at that. Instantly. Here he comes. He's going to turn. He's going to nail it. This is more his size. That tube jig is a little bit too big for him. This is his. This is more his meal right now, though. He wants it on the bottom, though, for sure. Oh, there's another one with it, a smaller one with it. Come on. Oh, here he comes back. Line it up. Got him. That was cool. Like I said, that tube jig was just a little bit too big for this fish. And it seemed like as soon as I got that spoon down there, like it took like what, a matter of 20 seconds, one circle, turned on it and crushed it. But we already know it's not that big. But for not catching a fish all day yesterday, this feels pretty good right now. I'm not gonna lie. Ah, I lost him right there at the hole. That's okay. Not really, it's not a huge thing if I always get them up, especially when they're that big. If you don't have to handle them all the time, there's nothing wrong with that at all. For me, the fun part is getting them to actually eat, getting them to commit. So yeah, that's the start to the day. Nothing wrong with that at all. As you can tell, I didn't show anything from the setup at all. I did have a beautiful sunrise as I was getting everything ready. Day three, there's no video from day two. I just didn't have a great day in terms of fish being caught. I did have a great day on the ice. It was very nice out. There's a video from yesterday though on Jay's channel, who is behind me there somewhere. We had a pretty fun day in terms of lake trout fish in the morning. Went and had a little burbot competition in the evening, which I caught nothing. But there is a link in the video in the description below here for Jay's day two video. So if you want to see me on day two, go there. Oh, here he comes. Oh, that's a nice fish. That's a little bit better fish. Just come in and crush the spoon. That fish I haven't seen on the camera at all. That's a little bit better fish for sure. That fish caught me by surprise because it come right over that sloping rock there. And then all of a sudden I looked over. It was like, yeah, it's already on the spoon. It ate it. Yeah, that's a little bit better fish for sure. I'd say probably high 20, low 30 inch fish, something like that. A little bit nicer. It's gonna be here right away. Here it comes. Oh yeah. Oh, come on, baby. There we go. Oh, that's a big burbot. Okay, well that was I did not expect that at all. That thing came out of nowhere, and that is a jumbo burbot. Wow, that was insane. Look at that. That is a big burb. They shouldn't be here this time of the day. Jay, is the competition still on? That was crazy. I couldn't even tell it was a burb, but it came in so fast. Okay, send her home.
Nice.
Awesome. Well, Jay, boom.
That was good.
Oh, there's one on there too. Come on. Oh, look at that. Here he comes. He's gonna eat it out of the rock now. Here he comes. Got him. That was crazy. I got him. For that fish to chase it so much, and then finally what actually caught him was putting it down on the rock and just hardly moving it. Their trout are so weird in that sense. You can learn so much from the underwater camera and just watching them. Like, I love fishing with the flasher, but you can't beat an underwater camera when it comes fishing for lakers. Like I said, I knew he was gonna be little right from the start. I could tell. But right now, I'm now put up my fish catching percentage by 300. just giving them the dirty beating right now. This is awesome. Trout three of the day. Let's send her home. Nice. Oh, this fish is chasing me on the water column right now. Come on. Come on. Two of them. I got him up at 49 feet. Come on. Oh, here he comes. He's charging it. Three of them now. Come on. A little bit higher in the water column. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Here he comes. Come on. That fish just ate that piece of chum and just took it away. That's so fun. That's so funny to watch. Picked up the chum and took off. That's crazy. I got a fish chasing me up the water column still. Oh, got him. Got him. I got that fish all the way up to 35 feet before he finally hit it. Unfortunately, you're not going to be able to see that because I don't have my flasher camera going. So you're just going to have to take my word for it. But that is trout four, or fish four of the day. Trout three. Not big, but I kind of knew that for sure. Oh, easy. Let's give you a little wash. See, Jay said that this trout was big, and it is big for him. Like, he hasn't seen a lot of big lake trout, so this is actually a pretty good fish for him. Do you want to put this on the end of your line and reel it in, Jay?
Looks like good bait, yeah.
Yeah, Jay would like to take that. He's doing some close-ups right now because, well, that's what his video is going to be about me today.
The Clayton Schick Show, everybody.
We're going to send you home. Actually, this is the biggest one I've seen right here. This is the biggest one I've seen. Come on. Oh, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. It looks really big when it's right by the camera. Oh, it sees my bait. It's going down towards it. Come on. Oh, it didn't like something. Come on. Come on. Here it comes. He's going right to my bait. He's right going right to it. Oh, that's a good fish. That's a big fish. That's a big fish. Come on. Come on. You can tell when they're at the camera, they all look big, but when they get down towards your bait, and I've got my camera super far away, you can tell that was definitely a bigger fish, especially compared to everything else I've caught today. That was a very nice fish. Well, I've just seen the biggest fish I've seen in the last 3 days, so I'm going to my staple, my fluorescent chartreuse tube jig, plain Jane. I do have a strip of Cisco belly meat on it though, but that's probably my biggest confidence bait when it comes to big lake trout. Big fish, big fish, big, come on, monster, oh baby, come on, big, it just swam straight through, it hasn't done anything yet, come on, turn around, come back, that was big. Here it comes. Come on. Yes! I got him! Big fish! I got him to eat. Oh yeah, he came back when that jig got active and crushed it. Big trout, baby. Oh yeah. Oh, big fish. Big fish. Oh, that was awesome. I was standing up. And I looked over, Jay, can you grab my flasher cord just to make sure? Jay, get my flasher out of there. And then we got to watch my underwater camera as well too. As I was saying, that was incredible. I was standing up, I looked down at my hummingbird action, I saw a big mark. So I started to pay attention. I looked over and I saw this big trout kind of just swim right by. And he didn't even look at anything. So I grabbed my jig off the bottom. I started actively jigging it. He must have turned around somewhere there once he saw it come back and just smashed it. Oh. My heart is racing. This is unbelievable. Oh, I have no idea right now because I don't have the hummingbird down. I don't know what depth he's at or anything. Are you kidding me?
Oh, Jay, I'm nervous for you.
Jay, can you turn that GoPro just kind of facing towards me a bit? Yeah, bring that up. Bring that up. Thank you. This is awesome. We got a crew with us today a little bit. So right now, somebody can actually bring the camera cord up, so I'm not going to have to deal with that at all. Oh, dude, this is a big fish.
Man.
Look at this. Oh, this is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Yeah, might as well just move it out. Yeah, get the camera moved out. Oh, I'm just shaking. Oh, yes. We have been... No, I'll probably grab it, I think. We'll see. We'll see what happens when it gets to the hole. We've been fishing the same hump for... This is the third day now. I had a tough day yesterday. Never caught a fish. And as you saw by the video so far, I've had a great start to the day. Caught a bunch of fish. I saw one pretty good fish. I got some stuff going on down there. He's moving side to side. He's just dogging me right now, though. I've got my drag, like, cranked right now. Jay's going to clean my hole out a little bit. And he's being super careful to not hit the line. You got to be very, very cautious with that. Oh.
This is it. We kept fishing the same spot for 3 days. Clayton's like, there's big fish here. I know there's big fish here. And last couple days, we saw fish on the camera. They didn't want to eat. Today, they are eating. We've had stable weather.
Jay, I'll let you land it, probably. Okay. I'll let you land it.
Should I take all my clothing off?
Together. Oh, I got a pretty long leader, so we should see that, if anything, first. Oh, I'm just vibrating right now. I can't believe that fish came back.
Oh. I haven't landed a fish for someone else in a while. This makes me nervous.
I'm nervous too. I'm nervous. I don't know if I've ever had anybody land my fish through the ice, Jay.
You normally fish by yourself.
I know. This is crazy. I got a pretty good hook set on him. This rod is just doubled. Using the same gear as always. Just my Lake Trout precision rod. This is the 40 incher. Oh, baby. 4,000 Stradic, so I can really give it to him when it's my turn.
Should I tighten the drag?
No, okay. Don't touch that thing. See my fluoro yet? It's gonna be getting close. I know I'm getting close right now. That was incredible. I can't believe it came back and ate like this. This is insane. Oh, he's doing funny things. What?
No, it's big. I'm nervous.
Oh, there's a leader. I want to go really slow with it. You know what? I might even stand so I can see for once.
Oh yeah, there's big fins. Big old fins. Dinosaur, folks.
Oh baby. This could be my PB through the ice, honestly.
That's big. That's a big fish.
Where is it doing right now?
Just let him do his thing.
Okay, talk to me.
Yeah. Oh, his head.
Talk to me. Yeah, just let him. Let it. The Tube Jig's got a trailer on it too.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, let him. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh! All I'm doing right now, I got the fish underneath here. I'm gonna open its mouth. I'm gonna pull the hook out when it's in here. He is hooked good. He was not coming out with the way that hook turned. I love that. Love that. Got the treble in him too, right in the side. Nice. Hook is out. So the hook's released right now. I'm gonna bring him up on the bump board. I want to do a quick measurement with him. I'm curious to see what it is. He's got a big nose. Do you want me to help? Yeah.
Just when he's dripping, just so I can get one slow-mo shot, then you can measure him, okay?
Oh, baby.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, that's it. Okay, I got it.
Look at the nose on that thing.
Monster.
Look at the nose. Oh, 38.9 maybe? 39 and a half.
Man, that's a big fish.
39 and three quarters?
Perfect.
Oh, 39 and three quarters, which guess what? That actually makes it my PB through the ice. Unbelievable.
You know,
pulling it? My hands are shaking.
Oh, that is such a good tail.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. She's gone.
Yep.
Unreal.
That's the one. That's why you waited out.
So good. Thanks, boys. That was so awesome having everybody here. Somebody pulling the camera cord out and we got stuck in it like you see in like 95% of my videos. This is unbelievable. What a start to the day. And honestly, it's like 11 o'clock right now. We got lots of time left. Ba-bam! Well, as you can see, different camera angle. Just because I took about 20 minutes since I caught that fish, got everything situated, organized again, ready to go. Like I said, when I put this jig on, this tube jig, I haven't used it for 2 days now. This has been my number one color, hands down, for big fish. From last year into this year, and I haven't used it for the last 2 days, and I was like, oh, I just gotta put it on. It's just like, it's such a confidence bait for me. And I know obviously the right fish came by too, right? It's like, it's not all, the only reason I caught that fish was because of this color, but it's what your confidence is in, right? And obviously now something like that, my confidence just increases even more on it. But yeah, so much went on. It was so awesome to have everybody here to kind of help with everything. Jay grabbing the fish, the transducer, somebody grabbing the camera out of the water so it wasn't gonna get stuck. It's just awesome with so many hands on for that stuff. So yeah, epic. That was like a huge moment, especially after yesterday, not catching a fish all day, grinding out, still having the confidence to come back in one of my number one confidence spots on this lake too. So at the Pap Lake, you did it again, baby. Bam! Got a bunch of smaller fish down there right now. I'm gonna give them the spoon. Even though I just caught a big fish, I still like catching fish in general. Like, I don't always want to have to chase big fish. I think I'm getting a lot better than I used to be. I've got very jaded and got to a point where almost what a term would be called like a fish snob, that I always want to just chase like the biggest of fish possible, right? Like anything small, you'd never see me put a smaller spoon on or something like this, but being able to see them eat like this on the camera, it just adds so much more excitement and you're learning things. I've definitely matured, you could say, when it comes to catching types the size of fish I want to catch. Now I just want to catch fish, but don't get me wrong, I love hunting big fish more than anything. Just saw another big fish, or a good fish. What do you, Jay, have a talk with me for a sec. When people say...
50 pounds.
No, when somebody says, what's the difference between like a good fish, a big fish, a giant fish, a monster fish? What's your order? Good fish, and then big fish,
yes.
And then monster, and then giant is my order.
And then mega.
Mega giant.
And then that Monzi. Is.
But I think it's, yeah, Monzi, but it's like different for everybody, right? Like I don't have a problem when somebody says I caught a giant lake trout and it's 37 or 38 inches, because for where they're from in that area, and maybe that's the biggest fish they've ever seen.
Yeah.
It's a giant to them, right? So it's like, we just don't use, we use those terms differently. If I say like my thumbnails are like big lake trout and somebody's like, that's a giant. I always think, well, it's not a giant, but to them it might be.
You've seen the biggest lake trout in the world.
Right.
Some of them, so.
Yeah.
They're megas.
They're megas. Oh, look at this fish turn on it. Here he comes, he's gonna eat that spoon. Got him, got him, got him. Not a big guy, just a little guy. I had the jig down there and those fish were kind of circling the jig a little bit, but they wouldn't eat it. As soon as I gave them a smaller presentation, we're on. And we got him. He's almost at the hole already too. And I already know he's gonna be smaller, but that's okay. That is okay. It's fun to catch some fish. Come on, little guy. Come on. Oh, right there, perfect. Right there, I don't even have to deal with him. Release them at the hole. That's that Super Leach Flutter spoon. I've given this thing a lot of airtime lately, and it has been really good. They seem to catch the fish when they've been finicky, for sure. Well, quick little update. It is 3 o'clock. Is it 3 o'clock? It is 3 o'clock. Haven't moved. Same hole. Got my dead bait out behind me. But what is going on is the sun is starting to get behind me, so I'm going to literally do a complete 180 here. I'm gonna fish the exact same hole, but I'm gonna fish it from the other side. So let's move everything over there, camera gear. I might even move the sled over there so I have something to lean against as well, I think. Okay, there we go. Well, I did move the sled over, but I did set up the chair so I can relax a little bit as I fish. Perfect view. Still sun tanning, life's good.
Oh, spoon's dancing. You gonna come up and eat it? Here he comes. Got him. Got him. Couldn't get him to eat it off the bottom, but he liked a little bit of a dance there just above him. That's kind of nice fishing outside. You can make a big giant hook set and not hit the ceiling. Well, had a little bit of a lull, like I said, but all of a sudden there's a bunch of fish on the camera again. And this one. Oh, okay, 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 okay. Yes, I know, you can dart around so much because you're small enough. Okay, okay, okay. That'd be a good eating size trout right there. Okay, okay. Spoon will pop out easy because it's nice and barbless. There we go. Not gonna mess around too long. Gonna get that trout back down. Beauty. Beauty, beauty, beauty. Just laying, giving him a licking. Dirty little licking. Oh, got fish down there still. Still two or three fish down there right now. They're having a little peek at the chum right now, it looks like. Let's see. Get that spoon back there and get another one. It's funny how it's like every fish is different. Some fish will eat it off the bottom. That fish wouldn't, and I brought it up a little bit and come right at it and nailed it. Every fish is different. The flasher only gives you so much information. Oh, is that he's gonna come to it? He liked it when I fell right to him. He liked it. Oh, here he comes. He's small. He's probably smaller than the last fish even. Do I really want to catch you? Do I really want to catch you? Ah, who am I to judge? Oh, he's circling. Look how frisky he's getting in and out. Oh, he's going to charge it right now. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, anticipation's real. Tiny. He's a small one. Oh, another one coming to play. I got two fish coming to play with me right now. A little bit of competition's good for him. Oh, I missed him. Missed him. Is he going to give me another chance? If he felt the hook, he definitely won't give me another chance. But there is two of them down there. Missed him. Way to go, Clayton. Oh, I scared that one away. Oh, yeah, he might give me another chance yet. Must not have felt any hook. Two of them. A little bit of competition's always good between fish because they just... they want to eat it before the other one eats it. It takes away some of their senses. Oh, he's getting so close. These fish remind me so much right now of like watching them like sight fishing in a sight fishing hole. Just like sitting right above them, they dart in and out, in and out. Same type of thing, just 65 feet down. They come right up to it and turn off. Why? Come eat. My little snack. I'll probably release you. Come on. Let's put it down to the bottom for a sec and see what happens. I'm gonna drop it down to the bottom, see if he follows it down. Smack down. Oh. If I had to choose between the two of you, I'd really like that darker one just because it's a little bit bigger. Both are very small, though. Very small fish. They wouldn't even, if that tube jig was down there, they probably wouldn't even look at it. It's a big meal for them. But this spoon, oh, got him. Oh, like I said, that was the smaller out of the two. I worked with those fish forever. Like, that's like a 2 or 3 minute play-by-play. Who knows if I put that little sequence on the video, this is gonna be a really long video. Okay. Just another, perfect. There you go. Turn yourself around. Turn yourself around, or do I have to come down there and help you? He's so big, he can't even turn himself around in the hole. Okay, here, I'll give you a little boost there, bud. There you go. Yeah, fish is so big, he got stuck in the hole. Unbelievable. Okay, boys and girls of all ages, I'm wrapping her up for today. Sun setting. Today was like awesome. There's no really word to explain it. Caught a pile of fish.
caught a big laker. I've been lucky to put some big lakers on the ice this year and last year, and today was my PB laker through the ice, so that's pretty awesome. PB, Jay says I got a title for it. So yeah, not clickbait, ladies and gentlemen. PB is for the truth. Maybe only by a half an inch or three quarters of an inch, but it's what it is. It was a big fish, I'm not gonna lie. I was happy to have my buddy Jay here with me. And as I've already said in all the videos leading up to this and this one, make sure you check out his channel. This video wasn't super technical. It was more full of action. It was lots of fun, awesome moments. So thanks for watching, and don't forget, get outside.